Now, sixth and finally, in verse 8, we come to the last way that God keeps us, and that is that he keeps us continually. But in particular, he keeps our schedule and our routine eternally. The Lord will keep your coming in, your going out from this time forth and forevermore, the psalmist says. So this psalmist is on a voyage in the wilderness of Israel, and he hasn't arrived at his destination yet. And so notice how he looks at God's guardianship over his life as an eternal process, never to be finished. He doesn't look at to the day when he will no longer need to be guarded. He's looking at himself and telling us, too, that we need to place our childlike dependence on God from this time forth and forevermore, meaning we'll never graduate from depending on God. Even in heaven, we will be weak and lost without Christ as our way and God as our trust. Now, I think if there's a promise in this verse, then it is that God is promising a safe trip through the pilgrimage of this life. But that includes all things from physical problems to our spiritual issues. Right? Physical problems that restrict our ability to travel are included in this, because that's a result of evil. Many of us are feeling the result of that during this coronavirus quarantine right now. But God will keep us eternally, not just physically. He'll keep us eternally, which captures the spiritual. He will not only keep us during our going out and coming in through this lifetime, but also through the next, that is from this time forth and forevermore. And so this is speaking of the perseverance of the saints and eternal security. Some of you are really familiar with that, those statements. The perseverance of the saints and eternal security could be wrapped up in the wrapping paper of a doctrine. It would be the doctrine of Christology, because it's Christ that is keeping us to heaven and who is assuring our salvation, okay? So God, through Christ, will keep you for heaven. That is, you're going out of this life forevermore. I think 1 Peter 1:3-5 says this so well when Peter writes, "Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. According to his great mercy, he has caused us to be born again to a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, to an inheritance that is imperishable, undefiled, and unfading," now listen, "kept in heaven for you, who by God's power," that is the power that made, same power that made mountains, "by God's creative power, are being guarded through faith," the same faith that this psalmist has in verses 1 to 2, that looks to the Creator for his help. "By God's power is being guarded through faith for a salvation ready to be revealed in the last time." In other words, Peter is saying that God is guarding those who come into life, that is those who are born again, and he's guarding those who are going out of life and keeping their inheritance kept for them in heaven. God is keeping our going in and our coming out through this life. God is keeping, let me show how God is keeping our going out. 2 Timothy 4:18 really says it well. "The Lord will rescue me from every trial and evil deed and bring me safely into his heavenly kingdom." Okay? So the Lord will rescue me, Paul says, from every evil deed. That's verse 7 of Psalm 121. "And he will bring me safely into his heavenly kingdom." That's verse 8. "He will keep my going out." But I said we can have the same confidence that Paul did because we have Christ as our guard. He assures it. And in John 17:12, Jesus prays to God about his disciples. "While I was with them, I kept them in your name, which you have given me, and I guarded them, and not one of them has been lost." You see, guarding, and Jesus is guarding us too. But notice that Jesus is our guard of our future, but also our beginning. It also includes our beginning and all parts of our life, even now. And that's what is captured by the phrase, "from this time forth." From this time forth, forevermore, Jesus is guarding us. As Charles Spurgeon has said about this verse, our exits and our entrances are under one protection. And his name is Jesus, the door, in John 10. He's the door. For that reason, Philippians 1:6 says, "And I'm sure of this," Paul says, "that he who began a good work in you will bring it to completion at the day of Jesus Christ." And so, we know that Christ began a good work in us by ending his life for us. That is how we come into life. We come into life because Jesus Christ ended his life for us. That's how he keeps our coming in. And Jesus will complete his good work in us because he rose from the grave, and we will rise with him. And that too is how he will guard our going out, because he rose from the grave. That's the way that Jesus went out. And so we can be sure that is the way that we will go out as well. Let's pray. Father, I just pray that your word would comfort us to Christ and help us realize that you are our soul guard through Jesus Christ. I pray that we would look to you above the geography that we face and the challenges that we have in life and realize that you are bigger than it all and you want to keep us in this life. And we pray this in Jesus' name.